لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير، ونشهد أن محمدا بشيرا ونذيرا وعبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد إمام المتقين وسيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، لا إكراه في الدين، قد تبين الرشد من الغي، فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استم سك بالأروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. صدق الله. Dear brothers and sisters, today is the March 3rd and Jamadiul Akhir 4th. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this community with a weekly Friday congregation where we talk about the conditions of our own families, community in totality, so that we face the challenges in the world collectively. And that is why today I have chosen the topic, Message to Canadian Muslim Youth. The verse I recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, there is no compulsion in religion. Certainly, right path is distinct from the wrong path. Whoever refrains from evil distractions and abides by Allah, then such has grasped the most trustworthy handhold that would never ever break. Almighty Allah is hearer and the knower. Youth have a very important place not only in the community of Muslims, but for this nation, Canada, as a whole. In Canada, our Muslim youths are no different than any other youths when it comes to facing the challenges of life, from childhood to puberty, and getting a right direction of their future profession. During the course of such a journey, our youth will be needing prudence in decision making, attaining pious behavior, entertaining the given education of their choice, and living a life free from the contradictions of being religious, while surroundings may not support the kind of religiosity which a Muslim youth may like to practice. religiosity by all means would make a youth on high stream of morality, honesty, mindfulness, and it would provide more focus upon academics than the wasteful nature of distractions and gossips which we always see in the Facebook, in the press, all around. Such a self-proclaimed discipline should not mean seclusion, but it should result in more intermingling of our youth with the rest of the youth of this great nation, with all possibilities, where commonality among students are maintained with high moral values. As an exemplary virtue in terms of ethics, freedom to express respect to others without any animosity of any kind among the students. A Muslim youth would be obliged to make choices which do not violate the forbiddance and allow the indulgence with what is clearly permitted in the book of Allah, Al-Quran, and also in the Constitution of Canada. Such don'ts and do's should be clearly understood to safeguard our youths without violating one's right in this country, what is permitted within the norms of Canadian values. I request my fellow Muslim brothers and sisters and youths of Canada, let us be truthful. Let us be trustworthy. Let us be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us hold patience. Let us be focused what we desire for us and for the community and for the nation. Let us be punctual and be consistent as per the guidance given by the last messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our youths, like adults, need not live a challenging double life in the mainstream of a Canadian living. Personal responsibilities towards Islamic values are never in clash with the Canadian statutes and the Charter of Rights. Such are complementary to each other. In terms of rights of others, permission to practice in law does not mean to we Muslims obligatory, but with respect to the rights of others. We as Muslims too have permission to practice our religion the best way possible without the violation of any norms or laws in this country. We have full right for our religious obligations, entertain our virtues, and respect others too for their constitutionally permitted deeds. For example, whether we like or not like, but when the Canadian statutes allow certain things for others, we have to develop a sense of tolerance, but we have to be as mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about such deeds which are not part of Islamic values. But we tolerate them because the law of this country is also to be upheld. For example, gender recognition, religious rights, and peaceful oppositional oration wherever and whenever. When given an opportunity, a Muslim youth should be able to deliver knowledge correctly with a direct reference from Quran and the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and feel free to stand by deeds what he has expressed or she has expressed. Living by example and seeking upon such example is more effective than that rhetoric we listen all around in the television and in the social media. One point must be borne in mind. Our professional excellence should never be affected in futile arguments, allegations, and distractions as the satanic forces want our youth to be distracted. Within, you shall be, or we shall be, a convictional Muslim, and our actions externally should never be offending so as to be focused upon our own excellence in the Canadian society. Dear brothers and sisters, the majority of Muslims in Canada feel Muslim first and Canadian second. This is a question often posed by the extreme right to the Muslim and then criticized later. Such an expression shall not be uttered, as our religion directs all Muslims to remain loyal and committed to the laws of the resident country. And being a citizen, every Muslim shall be following the sense of loyalty to Canada and its constitution. Having said so, being Muslim means faith to Islam, faithful loyalty to Canadian constitution. Every Muslim youth, like adults, should express undeterred honor of being Canadian and Muslims in the same level. But we all know that we are born because of the mercy of Allah. The first thing we as a Muslim recognize is the one God, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. The pressure to answer for violent attacks carried out by some unfortunate Muslim perpetrators has driven some of our young Muslims in Canada with a dilemma, not to mention the reaction being shown in Montreal mosque where few of us were killed. It has been understood by youths that to be a Muslim in Canada today is to be a person of scrutiny. That perception should not exist in our mind. Such a perception should be negated all around. We are as genuine citizens of this country as the aborigines of this country. So, we are the mainstream Canadians. For the youths, take the benefit of youthfulness before old age. So said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Religious responsibility starts from the beginning till at the most consciousness of mind remains as consciousness diminishes by we get older. That is why the youthfulness has to do a lot of work to establish truthfulness among us, within us, and around us. Appreciate your youthfulness. Don't spend your prime time in wrongdoing, inability in childhood, mischief of making in youth, and weakness in old age should be transformed into wholesomeness to become an ideal citizen, ideal Muslim within, to reap the fruits in this world and reap the fruits in the world hereafter. Dear brothers and sisters, every Muslim youth should speak loud enough against radicalism, extremism, and terrorism, which are the inventions of satanic hysteria, which has divided Muslims all over the world and has left us defenseless. But of course, those who recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who read the Quran, those who follow the tradition of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. We have inherited character and virtue from the last messenger prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the prophet, the best example, who is the shining example unto whom the creator Lord of the universe proclaimed, wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. Thou Muhammad, you stand upon the highest pinnacle of behavior. We as youth must live with such a behavior by loudly rejecting the perpetrators of animosity between Muslims and non-Muslims in this country. We Muslims have to be an example on the path of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This country is of multiculturalism, multi-religious, multi-religion, and these two are the main identities of Canada. Honor it by living in it, and Canada would never disown you by the liking of its citizen and through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As per the survey conducted by Environics Institute between November 2015 and January 2016, Muslims Canadian have been found to have very strong attachment to this country, Canada, and feel that Canada is heading in the right direction. So do we. But challenges are there. Fortunately, 83% of Muslim Canadians report being very honored and proud to be Canadian, compared to 73% of non-Muslim Canadians. Thus, oh my fellow Muslim brothers and sisters and our youth, we should stand tall by our true virtues of Islam and being Canadian at the same time. We shouldn't allow anyone to raise finger on us as a Muslim, but they should appreciate us being a Muslim who will be honest, intelligent, and a source of peace within and all around in Canada. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the feet of the son of Adam shall not move from before his Lord on the day of judgment until he is asked about five things about his life and what he did with it, and about his youth and what he wore it out in, about his wealth and how he earned it and spent it upon, and what he did with what he knew. Jami Tirmidhi. Similarly, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentions, the Prophet said, seven are the persons whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give protection with his shade on the day when there would be no shade but that of him on the day of judgment. Who are those? A just ruler, a youth who grew up with the worship of one God, a person whose heart is attached to the mosque, two persons who love and meet each other and depart from each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a man whom a beautiful woman of high rank seduces for illicit relationship, but he rejects this offer by saying, I fear my Lord the God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person who gives charity and conceals it to such an extent that right hand doesn't know and what the left has given. And a person who remembered Allah in privacy and his eyes shed tears. Dear brothers and sisters and my youths, let us remember what we talked today. Be a source of guidance to our members of the family, to the community, and also a source of strength to the Canadian society based on morality, righteousness. وَقُولَ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي مِنْ كُلَّ ذَنْبٍ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.